Why do we never get an answer when we're knocking at the door with a thousand million questions about hate and death and war? Is when we stop and look around us, there is nothing that we need in a world of persecution that is burning in. It's not the way that you say it when you do those things to me. It's more the way that you mean it when you tell me what will be. And when you stop and think about it, you won't believe it's true that all the love you've been giving has all been meant for you. I'm looking for someone to change my life. I'm looking for a miracle in my life. And if you could see what it's done to me to lose the love I knew could safely leave. It's not the way that you say it when you do those things to me. It's more the way you really mean it when you tell me what will be.
Anti-Afro Svengalis, let me tell you what I did. When I was recording this video, this song came to mind. And it really illustrates the tone and the tenor of these messages that I've been getting, in particular in the last several days, regarding Lenin honor. I really shouldn't limit it to the last several days because these sentiments have been shared over time. When people learned that me and Gerald were no longer rocking with Lenin honor and vice versa, we were no longer friends, etc. But one thing I want to point out, people having these types of feelings, because these were the types of feelings people were expressing. I thought about posting some of these messages and I thought, nah, that's probably tacky to do that. But this is what we have to keep in mind. People will try their hardest. They'll do whatever they can to try to force you to feel how they want you to feel about a situation. And we've seen here in these particular YouTube streets and blocks, people will go to the ends of the earth to the point of threatening your life, threatening to rape you, threatening to rape your children and your wife and your want to come to your house. They want you to express feelings that they insist that you're feeling and that you should be feeling. And this is what I experienced with the situation with Lenin honor. So many of the feelings that people are expressing aren't the feelings that I had. Now, I don't want to discount the feelings of the sincere and well-intended who very clearly expressed anger. They were upset. They didn't like what happened. They expressed they were hurt. They were shocked because of the things that they learned. But keep in mind, this is something that was going on for a while. It was shocking because it hit people like a ton of bricks. But the feelings that so many people who do not have good intentions, I'm talking about the people who don't have good intentions, wanted me to feel, insist that I'm feeling, simply is not the case. So I recorded a video. I was almost done with the video. And the song kept swirling in my head when I was recording the video because I was thinking about all these messages that I've been getting, that Gerald's been getting. And I said, you know what? Let me go back and record beginning of the video. I'm going to leave the commentary as it was originally because I want my original feelings to be chronicled because that's how I felt. When I recorded the video, I did not want to seem insensitive, but that's how I feel about the situation regarding Lenon Honor and what he's doing with this channel, which is prompting people coming up with all these different videos, saying all these different things, bringing my name up, running scenarios. And people have a right to have their opinions about things, but you cannot force people to be in a position with respect to their feelings and thoughts regarding things that simply doesn't exist. People want a fantasy. People want something to exist the way it was, but it just isn't the way people try to make it out to be in most instances. So I'm going to continue with the video as it originally was. So don't touch that dial. After you hear, buyer beware. Anti-Afro Svengalis, I thought I would come on here to post this video because I, frankly, I'm getting perturbed of getting all of these emails and these messages that are being held in queue that I'm not going to post about Lenon Honor and Lenon Honor's channel. There's a simple question. What is the reason that you're not going over to Lenon Honor's channel and asking Lenon what he's doing with his channel? What is the reason that you continue coming to me asking me what Lenon Honor's doing with his channel? If you want to know, go to the source. Oh, I get it. I think I get it, people. I don't mean to be sarcastic. You don't have a reliable link to Lenon Honor like you had before. You don't have a credible link to Lenon Honor like you had before. You don't have a trustworthy link like you had with Lenon Honor before. But it is what it is, people. What do you want me to do about that? I don't have any interest in learning about what Lenon Honor is doing with his videos. No, I'm not going to sign up to be a member of Lenon Honor's channel to find out what's happening on Lenon Honor's live stream, you people. I can't believe how many people have said, why don't you do it? What is the reason that you're asking me to do it? People, if you're sending me these messages, that means you were interested in knowing what Lenon Honor is doing on his channel, which means you are the ones that need to go over there and do whatever he's doing, asking you to do, sign up for a membership. That's something that you need to be doing. I don't have an interest. How many times do I need to say over and over again, if I am interested in something, if I really want to do something, if I want to be somewhere, I will be there. I will do any and everything I can to get somewhere where I want to be. And I have a lot of methods to achieve my goal. I don't want to be there. Can you get that through your heads, folks? Obviously not. So I don't know what fantasy you have in your head. I mean, are you going through some withdrawal symptoms regarding a relationship that's not even your relationship? That is in the past. I have a lot of things that I'm doing that I'm very satisfied with. So what is the reason that you continue to bombard me about Lenon Honor? Simply go and engage Lenon Honor. And I guess I do get the part about not having a reliable connection to him. And if you want to have my personal opinion, if I just on a quick pass up, think about it, it's a shame you don't have a connection to Lenon Honor the way you did before. I say it's a shame because your folks are in some sort of turmoil. You're suffering. I don't want to see people suffering. You people are really driving hard. Are you and Lenon going to be getting back together? I mean, the terminology that you people are using, it's very odd. I don't look at it that way. You look at it in a certain way. I don't know how it came to be that you all look at it as getting back together. There is no getting back together with anything. You really do look at it in a way that I never looked at it. Yes, Lenon honor was a close friend. Yes, we confided in each other, but that was in the past. This is now. If you want to know what's going on with Lenon Honor and his channel, you need to go and talk to Lenon, because very obviously he doesn't have a intermediary like he had before on his channel. But why don't you try and see if you can hook up with Lenon Honor and be his confidant? Well, I guess Lenon Honor should consider himself lucky that he did allow me so close into his inner circle, which was a very few people, and none of them are over there on the channel, because I'm not out here talking about the man's business like so many of those snakes, those backstabbers, and those connivers would have. By the way, people, I wanted to clarify something. Regarding the false police report that was filed on Lenon Honor, you know where that first came up? That came up on Dempsey Spears' channel, a licensed therapist who hosted that shit. TCTV was there, as were all those other demons whose names are contraband on this channel. They ran a live stream and they reported that shit right here live on YouTube. So it was not me bringing anything to YouTube violating Lenon's confidence. There are a lot of things about that situation that occurred that I haven't disclosed and I'm not going to disclose. But that was reported, repeat, by Dempsey, D. Durrell, on his channel. That was removed by YouTube. And how did that channel get removed? I'll tell you some more stuff you don't know, because I got that channel down for E&J. And I don't even like to get channels down, which is why you'll see me get up in hackles when somebody accuses me of taking down a channel. A channel is not that hard to get down, people. You just need to say the right thing. By the way, TCTV's channel could have been taken down very easily. It wasn't hard for that person who filed the lawsuit to get his channel down. Based on all the crap that he said about us, which was 1 million times worse, we could have gotten that channel down. We just didn't file any complaints. But it was the crap that they were saying about E&J that was so distressful that I went ahead and I got with YouTube and we got that channel down. And it was on that channel when they were running that live stream, the Run Lenon Run, and accusing Lenon of all this bullshit. And they identified exactly who called the police on Lenon. It was a false police report. If it comes down to it, we can get that live stream from YouTube. One thing you're not going to ever see me do is get up here and tell anybody any lies. Nothing I'm going to say up here is a lie. What I'm saying can be backed up because that live stream was run on Dempsey's old channel. So whoever wants to put me to the test, let's boogie on that. I don't know what to tell you. I'm doing other things. All the things that I'm doing, I'm not reporting here on YouTube. Yes, they are related to Umar Johnson. I will start posting Umar Johnson content again when I'm ready to do that. There were reasons why I didn't post Umar Johnson content, because of you thieves, because you're conniving, backstabbing demon freaks. Let me see, your handcuffs is at the top of the heap. When the channel was migrated, no videos were deleted. People are running around talking about all this crap. They have no idea what they're talking about. I was never under any legal threat. Legal threat? The only legal threat that I'm under, that would be related to my professional duties that don't have anything to do with YouTube. These are timelines and deadlines that I have to adhere to. Zero to do with Umar Johnson. So this talk about court, what is this about court? Whether it applies to Lenon Honor or not, I seriously doubt it. You know what it takes for a court order for people to take videos down? And let's say somebody's spooked. Okay, somebody's spooked, but what is a video going to do? Because somebody has videos on Umar Johnson and Conscious Energy, I wanted to just make a correction. No smoke or anything. I have the most Umar Johnson videos, 2,200 of them, and I still have every single video. Someone said Lenon had over 1,000. I'm not sure. I didn't count. But I'm the one that has the most videos. I want to make sure that's known because of the effort that we all together, and it wasn't just me, that contributed to the videos that I posted. that I still have, every single one of them. And there are several on the channel right here, but who was going to tell you to take down a video? What is a video going to do? Umar doesn't have any action he can take against anybody. Umar has threatened to kill us. Umar would have to open up the books. Umar doesn't have any legs or arms to stand on. That is ridiculous about somebody being threatened with court to the point they're going to take down videos. I'm going to leave it at that. But keep in mind, when people are desperate, they have no content, of course they'll go on a scavenger hunt for content and to be able to keep you engaged in their bullshit. That's what someone tried with me. And that's why I migrated the channel. They wanted to keep me involved with all of these copyright strikes, these fake copyright strikes. And that channel was removed by YouTube. My computer person says, why are you dealing with this? I thought you were going to move this channel so you don't have to deal with this crap. You're right. I went ahead and migrated the channel. Yeah. So this person thought he found a way to get me to communicate with him. I never communicated with this person except for sending him, like I sent everyone else, one of the August Archibald lawsuit versions or whatever. I never spoke to that person. And that person thought that they found a way to keep me engaged. And that is a way that people, if you are not engaging them and speaking to them, they'll try to find some way to get you wrapped up. And that was a way to disengage. And it was successful. Whether or not Lenon is doing that, I don't know. I haven't thought about whether or not Lenon is doing that. It's not my concern. That is Lenon's concern. I'm not thinking about what he's doing with this channel. I don't have any concern about what he's doing with this channel. I would only have one single issue with Lenon Honor and members only if it's a KKC situation. Someone professing not to give a hoot about us, and then all of a sudden we're getting these live streams of the host trashing us and lying on us and verbally abusing us and making up scenarios about us that were non-existent, then yeah, we're going to have a problem. I don't anticipate having that issue with Lenon because Lenon is not going to get on here, even on a members only live stream, and tell anything that he doesn't want to be known. He's not stupid enough to think he's going to get on a members only live stream and say something and think it's confidential or personal or won't be shared. That's the only thing I can think of. That other than that, I'm not going to be concerned about anything unless something comes our way. No, I'm not going over there to sign up. Why would I do that? I don't sign up for people's channels who I'm not rocking with. I don't understand that. And I have never understood that, people. But to each his or her own. One thing I hope everybody takes with the utmost intensity and determination and adherence when it comes to heeding the warning, buyer beware.